good are you at teaching your dog simple commands or even some really cool tricks?
Evidently not very
good.
It
can be easy to do despite what's happening here. To celebrate National Dog Day, which is tomorrow, we have Pooches at Play co-host and dog trainer Lara Shannon to teach us a few cool moves. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Lara.
What a beautiful bunch of dogs you have here.
It's a motley crew, isn't it?
Yeah,
it sure is.
We know that having animals is so important and it can do all sorts of wonderful things for your health, your well-being. Why is National Dog Day so important?
Well, National Dog Day was started up really to highlight the benefits that dogs bring to our lives, the health and physical, as well as really raise awareness about pet adoption and rescue and all the beautiful dogs that we should be saving, really.
Now, I have a dog and she's just so annoying because she won't do anything I say. How can you save me? What are some simple tricks to teach dogs?
Look, the biggest consistency is key and being really clear with them about what you want to do. So people think dogs understand what we want them to do. Sit. Well, we have to show them how to sit and we can't expect them to know how to do it straight off. So it's really about in little small doses, bit by bit, and being a firm leader.
Can you teach an old dog new?
Absolutely, you can. Look, you know, it takes longer and it's about unbreaking any bad habits they might have.
Yep.
And one of the biggest issues as owners, and I do it myself, is we inadvertently reinforce the bad behaviour. So that's often what's happening. So you might be going, oh, it's okay when your dog is doing the wrong thing, and then you wonder why my dog keeps doing that.
Right, gotcha.
That's generally.
Mean to your dog.
It's not about being mean at all. It's about if a dog, you're asking a dog to sit and it doesn't, and then you still kind of after a while go, oh, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. That's okay.
Okay.
So the dog learns
to be strong.
Have to sit.
Be strong, Joe.
I think I'm about to let Fluffy off the leash.
And look, it's Ruby, Ruby, pop, 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 pop. And also it's about motivating them. Ruby, come here, Ruby. I know I should, Ruby. Live television and dogs,
why
anything
jump up
can
and grab
go wrong.
Lara and I are old friends, aren't we? We've had Mitty.
Ruby.
Oh, it's like water skiing.
Ruby, you hold on to her, ready? And I'm going to show her the chicken. And then, Romy, I'm going to show you the chicken as well. This is what I've got. Come on, Ruby. Bop, 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 bop. Come on, Ruby. Yes.
Why is it always my dog that goes rogue?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Romeo.
Come here. Come here. Okay.
Ready?
Chaos.
Won't get this on the other networks.
Come on, back we go. Now, Romeo, as I said, right. Romeo, come here, good boy.
Hi, Ruby. Yep.
Yeah, good boy. Oh, anything can go wrong with live television. Radio.
So, Joe Casamento's, you know they say owners often resemble their puppies?
Romeo.
We didn't dress the same.
See if you can spot which dog is Joe Casamento.
Oh, she's such a lady.
She's such a lady. Apparently she did a big number two in the car park just before.
Oh, that's okay. So did Jono, so it's all right.
I'm going to let Romeo go.
I just
But now, Lara and I have been working together and I feel like every time... Oh, she's going to go.
Oh, I hope she doesn't go like she did this morning.
She's okay. She'll be all right.
No, as in go.
But I thought, oh, here we are. So we're chatting about... I think at this stage it was recall. She would run away from me in the park.
And this is the new Pooches at Play show that's on right. Yes. Which is super exciting. How did Joe's dog go?
Minty was actually really good with her.
Yeah. She's got a new issue now. Every time I speak to Lara, there's a new issue. It's yapping now. Yapping's the big one.
Yes, and again, look, barking and yapping is a big one, and that is something we do reinforce a lot as well.
Yeah.
When the dog is yapping for our attention, we're like, stop it, be quiet. Oh, or touch it.
Yeah.
Well, what's the dog just got? Our attention, which is what they want. So it's really, that's that whole reinforcing things that we do and don't want. So what you would do there when she's yapping, it's really hard, but ignore it.
Yes.
Oh. Ignore and as soon...
But the neighbours start yelling at
me. No, but as soon as she's quiet,
shut up!
That moment that she's quiet,
Oh, so what about the old citronella spray thing? Are you allowed to do that?
No, that would be the aversive kind of training.
Right.
So, and you know, that's really just frightening a dog. And what we want to do is we want a dog to understand the right behaviour. So it is about marking that really good behaviour.
Okay.
So you ignore until she stops.
That's right. And then you exactly.
Now, we can't let you go without Lara, without you showing us a few dog tricks.
I knew you were going to do that. So
is that possible today?
It is. Well, we're going to use little Ruby. It is. Look, you know, it's a high stress environment. So the thing with dog training is that you always want it to be in a familiar, low stress environment. Otherwise, dogs can't learn in a high stress environment.
All right.
So that's why it's all a bit overwhelming. I know it's a bit overwhelming for them all today.
Let's
give it a little go. I mean, Jerry Boy, he just sits perfectly for some food. Little Ruby normally does a big jump. So, Minty, do you mind?
Trying to steal the show.
You look like a real housewife from Sydney. I love it.
Exactly. So, Ruby. Yeah, so, Ruby, what we're going to do is we're going to get a stand. No.
Sit.
So this is all about motivating a dog. So clearly Ruby is highly motivated by roast chicken. So she's offering behaviour. Yeah. So what we're going to do is, I'm not giving it to her yet, we're going to do down. Yes, good girl.
Oh.
Good girl. Free. So, so what it is really is about marking that behaviour at the exact moment she gives it to me. So remember, don't reinforce the bad behaviour. Ignore it. And as soon as they stop barking or they stop jumping, then it's the yes and you give them what they want.
Yeah. But can I ask something? Say you're out and they yap at a little kid that comes up to them or snap or whatever. I mean, it's very easy to say ignore the behaviour, but you clearly can't in that circumstance.
So if that's a fear-based aggression usually, and what we'll do in that instance is it's up to you to be watching what's going on and to be mindful that Minty is starting to do that. So the best thing is to really try and take Minty away from that, and then take her away, and then when you are, she has a good experience with the child, slowly let the child slowly introduce them, and when she does the right behaviour, reward that, and it's just consistency and practice.
Also, if Minty does go missing, just check all the nail salons in your area.
You can tune into Pooches at Play on Saturdays at 2:30 p.m.
She wants to be
on the 10 and Win networks. Lara, thank you for bringing your love.